This is Solar PVDV from COP21 from Paris. We are together with Dr. Jane Goodall, who needs no introduction, and also the second person, actually, who also needs no introduction, with Mr. H. So I can tell you, Dr. Goodall, that this is such a big experience for me today and a big emotional moment that I'm with you, and also with Mr. H. I tried to ask him some questions about you, but unfortunately he didn't want to tell me anything yet, but maybe I can give Mr. H to you.
He was taught not to speak with his mouth full when he's eating yes. banana.
Yes, exactly. But this is actually the history of good, because you are a person who brings good to the world and who brings the truth to the world. And I would like to ask you, Dr. Goodall, when there was the moment, the first time when you thought, I have to do something for the planet, I have to do something for the world. Do you remember still this moment? Which was the second that you finally thought, I have to do something?
It was in 1986, and I was at a conference which brought together all the different people studying chimps in Africa. And at that conference, there was a session on conservation, which was shocking, like forests disappearing, but the bushmeat trade, the commercial hunting of wild animals for food. And I thought, I have to do something. And then learning that all around where the chimps are, people are living in such awful poverty, we can't even try and save the chimps unless we do something for the people.
Exactly. And I would like to ask you another question, because I cannot imagine how you are able, you know, be so active, to be around the world. What keeps you fighting? What gives you the strength?
Partly it's a sense of urgency. There's so much wrong with the world. And, you know, I've been given two gifts, I think. One is a health, and the other is a gift of communication. And when you're given a gift, I believe you should use it. And so that's one thing that keeps me going. And then I meet so many amazing, inspirational people. And there's our youth program. We've got about 100,000 groups of young people from kindergarten through university in 140 countries, all choosing projects to make the world a better place. It's very inspirational.
And I would like to ask you this question even more personal, because just before COP21, we had these terrorist attacks, and a lot of people, they canceled their trips to Paris. And in this moment, I thought, we cannot give up. We have to really be here. We have to unite. And I would like to ask you, what was your personal feeling and what made you to come to Paris? And what would you like to affirm by that?
Well, quite honestly, okay, there were terrorist attacks in Paris. I was in New York when the Twin Towers were felled. I've been in Congo when there was civil war and shooting outside the window. Same thing in Burundi. So just because there was a terrorist attack, that's not going to stop me doing what I feel I have to do. And fortunately, the French government was magnificent and decided they would host the COP21 as planned. Good for them.
And very often, people, they think that they cannot have any influence, yes? Because, for example, when we have some politician, when we have some celebrity, some Nobel laureate, of course, they feel that they have influence. But what I noticed, and also this is your message very often, that everybody on Earth actually can contribute. And anybody, you know, no matter what is their financial status, their, I don't know, nationality, can make something. Could you just justify that? But looking into this camera.
Well, I think it's really important. I think that so many people do nothing because they think about everything that's wrong in the world and feel, well, I'm just me, there's nothing I can do. But actually, if people start thinking about the consequences of the small choices that they make, what they buy, what they eat, what they wear, where does it come from, did it involve cruelty or destruction of the environment, and start making ethical choices, then millions and eventually billions of small ethical choices starts to move towards the kind of world we want. And I find that when people begin making small changes, they gradually get bigger because they get this feeling, I am doing something.
Thank you so much, Dr. Goodall. And last thing, because Actually, the first contact with your organization I had through Adam Hall, who is managing the program Million Solar Stars. And they are making solar installations in China, and now I think also around the globe. And I know that your organization is also involved a bit in clean energies. Yes? So what would be your message to the green, clean, and solar energy communities?
My message would be that this is desperately important because it's our reliance on fossil fuels, gas and oil, that is destroying so much of the world, is causing so much pollution, is adding to the greenhouse gases hugely, and we get climate change. So clean, green energy is the only way forward if we want to mitigate climate change.
Thank you so much, Dr. Goodall. And last question to Mr. H. If you agree with what Dr. Goodall said, could you just say something?
Yes, I agree. I think she's quite right.
Okay, thank you so much. It was a very touching moment for me. And Dr. Goodall, I wish you that you continue your way another 10 or 20 years.
And for me.
And I think that your work will stay in hearts, and it will continue with all the people around the globe. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And make some plug. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. That was Solar PV TV together with Dr. Goodall from Paris. Thank you so much.